If you notice here in Mark 2, starting at verse 13, you see Jesus pass by a man named Levi. Levi is at the tax booth. Jesus says, Levi, follow me. Levi drops everything and follows him. What catches my attention about this is how much power does Jesus must really have. Because Jesus, the Bible does not say that Jesus saw him at church and told him to follow him. The Bible does not say that Jesus was in board meeting and told him to follow him. The Bible says Jesus saw him at the tax booth and asked him to follow him. Y'all not with me? Levi is shamed by the church because of what he does. Jesus goes to him and asks him to follow him. Y'all still not feeling it? While Levi is in his sin, while he's actually in the place of sinning, Jesus shows up and says, yo, you the perfect person for my team. Oh, I wish I talked to somebody. To me, how so many of us feel like we have to clean ourselves before we can follow Jesus. And Jesus has the nerve to show up while we're laying in bed with the wrong person. And says, you exactly who I need. I wish I was talking to somebody anyway. Wow, we kidnap the individual. Jesus says, this is exactly who I want on my team. While Levi is messing up, messing around, he says, follow me. And Levi says, I'm going to drop everything and do just that. Jesus has a way of changing the unchangeable.
That's right.
And turning things around. And if we will connect to that type of power, we could do the very same thing in our neighborhood. We can do the very same thing with our government. We can do the very same thing if only we had that type of power. If only we were connected to that type of power. I told you before, but let me get away with it again. Too many of us are connected to outlets that have no longer power. And because so, we think that we're connected because connection is still available. But don't realize that just because we're connected to something don't mean it's producing real power. And the problem with too many of us is that we know we have no power. That's why we have to fight for positions in the church. Lord, help me. We show up in here because when we're in here, we feel a little more power. But Jesus changes a whole situation around by simply asking him to follow him. Now the Greek puts it in this way. The Greek says, the Bible says when Jesus saw Levi, the Greek says, when Jesus was watching Levi for a period of time. Y'all got filled. Lord, help me, Jesus. I need some help with you. Jesus had been watching this man mess up. It wasn't like Jesus didn't know who he was. He had a resume of all the crap this man had possessed in his life. And after reading his resume, he still said, you the person I want. What the church would look like if we had a position like that, when we see people and they don't look like us, even though on the inside they look just like us. And we say, you're welcome to this place. Can I be transparent with you? Can I be transparent with you? Lord, cover me right now. It is a problem when we are afraid to invite people to this church because of what might happen to them. Speak, Father. Some of us coworker. Because we know what goes on. We know they might not, they might be bruised if they come through these doors. Help me, Father. And because of the crap we do in this place, people are still shackled in our zip code because the place that's supposed to be given the power don't have no power. So many, we've been watching the news of all these hurricanes knocking these countries and cities out of the wazoo and leaving these places with no power. It's so funny because it might be a Hurricane Harvey in here. Might be an Irma in here. And the problem is, after they have done what they have done, we leave with no power. But understand.
Lord, use me.
But understand. You have access to power. We can change the community. We can set the oppressed free. And the truth of the matter is, we can set us who are in oppression in this building free. Understand that you don't need to have position to have power.
Somebody in here.
We gotta have power to change low income communities. We have to have power to set people who have bail money free. We need to have power to minister to the family who lost their child to police brutality. We have to have power to help those who cannot receive education because of the president that wants to end DACA. We have to have
You don't need position to have power. You don't need position to have power. And we see that in history. We see it in history. Position don't mean you have power, because when God gives you power, you don't need position. The bus driver on December 1st, 1995 had position, but Rosa Parks had power. LBJ had position, but MLK had power. You know Pharaoh had position, but Moses had power. Nebuchadnezzar had position, but the three people born had power. Haman had position, but Mordecai had power. Saul had position, but David had power. And 2,000 years ago, Satan had position, and through my Jesus, on the cross, they put
towards the cashier, and the boy said, "No, I can't do it, but can you do it?" Can you put your hands in the jar and give me some candy? The clerk looked puzzled and confused, but he went ahead and obeyed the command, and he got some candy and put it in the boy's hands. The mom, after they left the store, looked at her son and said, "What in the world's wrong with you? You have enough nerves to tell a man who's offering you candy to get it, tell him to get it for you?" The boy looked confused at his mother and said, "I wasn't trying to be rude. I just realized that when I looked at my hands, and I looked at his hands,
and praise your name.